Okay. So, good morning, good afternoon. Welcome to the webinar session number 6 in the year 2019. Today we have two topics. Introduction, that's the introduction. We have two topics. Florian Weisse from Product Management from the Cloud Topics will show us a little bit about the status of PostHub and what we currently do here. And after the session, we will talk a little bit about automation in post-processing and how it works with NX OpenAI, the possibilities you have, you can achieve, and which advantages you can get of this. So then, let me directly give it over to Florian. And Florian, just it's your show.
Yeah, thanks, Thomas. Yeah, glad to share. Good morning, everyone. Again, from my side, let this load for a second. I'll do have the honor to give you an update on PostHub 1.5. My name is Florian Weiser. I'm the program manager for the cloud activities in the NX Chem area. That means I'm trying to orchestrate all the cloud activities for NX Chem in the end. And one of those, it's been around for a while, we know that, but I think it makes sense to give you guys a short update what is there, what it's for, how does it look, to give you some starting points. I'll do that today. I'll try to spend not more than 15 minutes to give some room for short questions, and then Thomas some room for his topics. So long story short, I'll talk about PostHub for about 15 to 20 minutes and hope to give you an overview of what we do. So I think a lot of you guys have seen PostHub before, so I'll try not to talk about it too much. This slide I put into the presentation just to give you an overview where we came from. PostHub is one of the of our NX Chem cloud applications that we're working on. There are a few others, but actually the whole project group came from a different area. We're working together with our folks and friends from Siemens Motion Control. Those are the guys who built the Sinumeric controller. And the what we call Chem Server came around as a piece of technology to expose Chem functionality to a machine tool controller. Like, imagine we wanted to make certain functionalities available on a machine, on a machine HMI, so people can change CAM programs or look at it from various third-party clients, you know, like a machine controller, like a tablet, like a smartphone, and so on and so forth. This is where we came from, and then after a while we said, why just make this available to machine controller if we could make this available to through a web application, through a wider audience? So long story short, PostHub was born. This is about 2 years ago. We've been working on this for quite a while. And I can talk a little bit in the end why it takes us 2 years to get such a straightforward service running. But first, let me talk you through a little bit why we came up with PostHub. There are, first of all, a lot of reasons why we did it. If you've been active or have been active in the post-processing area, you know, it is not easy to find post-processors. We learn from working with our customers. If you do have a new machine tool, there's multiple ways of finding new post-processors. Either you know who to talk to, or you have a very good working relationship to one of our partners, or you have hearsay where to find post-processors. But generally speaking, we believe part of the reason it's so hard is not that there are not enough post-processors out there, or there are not enough partners who can help you with post-processors, but it is that it's hard to find those partners and be able to judge whether or not they have something you're looking for. So six of the reasons we identified, you see listed here on the slide. We believe with a primarily a unified post-processing library, this will help both our NX Chem customers who are looking for post-processors, and for content creators, for those who create post-processors and would like to make their post-processors available to more people and on a wider range and more easily, most importantly. Long story short, PostHub As the name implies, is a post-processor library which enables you to try post-processors out, to see if the post-processor does what you want, if it's good enough, it's bad enough, if it's a good starting point, and then initiate the communication with or connect two parties, those who are looking for post-processors with those who have good post-processors to offer. How does it work and what is it? I said already a lot of words. I'll go into a demo in just a second. I think slides are nice, but you guys are probably more interested in seeing it in action. There's a few bullet assumptions or a few specifics about PostHub. For us, it was very important. We did not just wanted to show a plain list. This has been around for years. There have been multiple attempts doing this. There was the GTEC list, no? There was the My Community Request Forum. There were multiple attempts on building up such a platform, but what all of them lacked and what we believe makes PostHub unique is the ability to try out a post processor, to really be able to, I can see my part file used with this post processor. Yeah? So very important for us is the actual NC code is generated. So what you see in a second is not pre-fabricated NC code. This is all happening live on the servers. And the second big part, which we learned from talking to our content providers, to our partners, is making posts available for tryout is challenging. Even with Post Configurator, there's still the challenge of giving it to a partner. The partner needs to install the post processor and needs to be able to run it. There's a lot of challenges for this process to be seamless. So we said, PostHub, it has to be easy, right? We want it to you to be able in a few clicks to try out a post processor or try out the next post processor without worrying too much where to install it, how to install it, and which dat file to modify. All those kind of things we wanted to get around. And we thought a web application is a good choice for that endeavor. Yeah. So I'll walk you through really briefly because first of all, I think I've talked to you probably about it before, but for those who haven't seen it, using PostHub is fairly easy, as I said, and you be the judge if that's true. Fundamentally, it's very easy. You upload your part file to our web service, and I'll show that again in a second. Then you use your part file to select the machine kit, yeah, one you want to try out. Then you click the post process button, you click get your NC code, you can charge, hey, that's the NC code I'm looking for. And if that is what you're looking for, you can get in contact with the partner to get a quote. Yeah? So that's it in short. I'm not gonna run you a video. I'll try a live demo. We did have a few technical problems this morning, but I hope they're resolved. So what you see here is the standard NX12. Yeah, it also works in the latest. I'm not sure what the latest 18 something something that's out at the moment. I have a little user function that you need. You can download. Yo, as a side mark, if you want to try out what I'm doing now, Thomas or I can point you to the right location. Everything you see is available online. It's in a we call it a technical demonstrator. So it's something like a beta evaluation. So everything I show you today, you can try it yourself after the after this meeting. So long story short, I have my test port here. It's a pretty standard, nothing special test port. Then we have this little user function here that you need that you can download from our servers. You need to specify where to upload it to, and then you click upload part and launch NXCAM Post Hub. What it will do, it packages up your part file, everything that's in your next session fundamentally, and uploads this to Siemens servers. So please make sure you're happy to upload this to our servers. The good news is we're not keeping any of it. As soon as you're done with PostHub, we're just deleting your data. We're just keeping it for the time you're active on the service. There's a little disclaimer. I'll invite you to read through it. There's nothing really unusual in it. The first step you get is a Chrome browser here, yeah, and you see your part file. You want to make sure your data was transferred successfully to our servers. Yeah. You can go through your program and see, yeah, it works. I know that's not very smooth through the Skype meeting, but believe me, you can interact with your part file. You can look at it. You can go through the individual operations and see, yeah, that's my part file. That's my tool paths I want to try out. The next important part, of course, is the post processor listing. Yeah, I mean, this is what you came for. Currently, we have 317 post processors listed on PostHub. And we tested all of those that they work. So you see a long list of post processors. Of course, we don't expect you to go browse through 317 post processors. Therefore, we give you filters here on the left that you can use to filter down the list to the selection you need. I'm going to go ahead and just go by author. You see, we do work together with quite a few partners to make posts available. You see them here. There's no restriction who can offer post processors here. It's just fundamentally those who we reached out to or who reached out to us to be part of PostHub. So here my question would be for you, if you're interested in being part of PostHub, either way as to try it out or to offer your post processors, please reach out to myself or to Thomas. We'll get you in contact. I'm going to use Phoenix PRM for this morning just because. Nigel, a good friend is maybe too far, but a good partner of us is in Australia, has two kits uploaded with us. You see there's additional information available on this kit. You see which few of the details, which controller, which manufacturer, which type, how many axes there are. You see that there's a sample NC code that is preset with the kit, yeah. So just to really fast give you an introduction. This is not based on on my part file, just to give you an idea what this is about. There is a sample part, I'll get to this in a second, and you can make your documentation available and find a similar kit. So long story short, let me select this kit. So what now will happen, it loads that that kit from Phoenix PLM. Yeah, and we'll put my part file into this machine. So you see my part file here, right? At Phoenix PLM, as usual, you can interact with the assembly tree. Yeah, you can get rid of certain elements you don't want to see. That's the same as it is in NX. Yeah, very straightforward. Once you're happy with it, you go to you do what you came for doing. Yeah? You post process. It tells me that there's an operation out of sync, but it will be just regenerate. What's now happening on server side is post processing the program, and you see that here on the right side. Yeah, you see it, this is the preview code. Very important. If this is a commercial kit, and that is one that I selected, commercial means Phoenix PLM actually wants to sell this kit. Hence, we're not giving out the whole NC code. It would be kind of pointless, because who would buy the kit then? So giving out only the first, I think, 200 lines of the NC code. Yeah, that's what you get. You can also post-process only certain aspects of the toolpath if you want. It's straightforward. I think you get the idea, right? If that's not what you're looking for, you can go back, can select a different machine. In this case is a Doosan, fairly large machine. Same story, you see how fast it is, right? This is how we want you to browse for posts. Okay, hey, that's not what I'm looking for. Yeah, that looks better. Let's give this machine a try. So now I posted it on a Doosan machine, yeah. See, look, the NC code looks different. I think you get the idea. This is how PostHub is supposed to work. If you're happy with what you're seeing, then you can go and contact author, this one, and then you get a contact. Yeah, it's Phoenix PLM. You get an email address and even a mail address if you want to send them a letter. Long story short, Siemens is not getting involved into the sales process. So as soon as you get in contact with the partner, in this case Phoenix PLM, Siemens is out of the picture. For us, the benefit is that you're able to find the post processor and that you're happy with NXCAM fundamentally, and that our partner can sell their post processors. This is all good enough for us that we don't want to get involved in the sales process. There's one more thing I would like to show you. There's this acceptance part. So if you don't want to use your own part, you can use one of theirs. You see Phoenix PLM uploaded two test parts for me to try out. The sense here is that they can show off UDEs, they can kind of show off a little bit better what they're doing. I'm gonna use this part for a second. What this will now do is we're not using my part as before. You see that here, not my part, now it's their test part. I can go to post process, I can click post process, and it'll give me, I think this is showing some trilling operations. Can even look at the toolpath. You see they're doing here all the fancy spot drills. I think you get the idea, right? Long story short, this is really a platform for you to find the post processor or for you to offer your post processors in the best way possible. We're more than happy to have discussions on feature requests or you would like to be part. This is why we're doing this today. So let me finish the slide deck up real quick. I'll save you the video. We have seen that. This is the overview of kits we have here right now. excuse me. You see, fundamentally, which is probably a nice overview, is the partner Siemens ratio. We have about 26 partner kits on the post. I think it's even a bit higher at the moment. The slides from December last year. We do a majority, of course, are Siemens post processors due to the fact we migrated some old post processors, but we're more than happy to change this. You get a little overview, so we get quite a good interaction with the tool. We have about, I think, 20, about 10 to 20 sessions a day in average. This is split on post processors, not that super interesting to see, but just to give you an overview of what's available on the tool today. Those are the partners currently we're working with. They're, like I said, this is the slide decks could be updated, but it doesn't matter. That we're working with, we're more than happy to add more. That's just the ones we started with. There are a few restrictions. I'm not going to go into too much details on that. This is our timeline. It's got moved out a little bit. We're still a little bit behind our mid to 2019 release. So fundamentally, where we are currently in the beta phase, in the PostHub 1.5 beta phase. Probably early next year, 2020, we want to have the PostHub 2 release ready to be used, meaning this is an actual full-blown Siemens service, and then we're probably going to work on a third release. We do have a lot of more ideas what to do with PostHub. I'm not going to go into too many details of that today, as we only have a short time frame. Long story short, this is around the corner and will become available early 2020. So I invite you to check it out, the current beta phase. Give us your thoughts. There's a little survey under the tool if you want to share your thoughts with us. If you do have post processors that you would like to make available, get in contact with us. And we're more than happy to work with you to get your stuff tested and then available on PostHub. That's it, fundamentally. That's me again. Again, I'm more than happy to, let's see what the time, we have about a couple of minutes for questions before Thomas probably has to move on. Other than that, send me an email and I'm happy to talk to you. So are there any short questions before we'll let Thomas talk about post-processor automation? No? Okay. Then, Thomas, I think you can move on if you like.
Yep. Thank you very much, Florian. Looks very promising. So cool. Okay, then let me take over again. Before I go forward with the automation post-processing, I just want to mention one small thing. For those of you which are using the NX Manufacturing Forum, maybe you recognize that they moved to a different place, and for example, all the videos are not longer available currently. So, what we did, I just want to show it shortly. All the videos from also this webinar sessions are now uploaded to a channel in YouTube. So just using Post Configurator in the search, and there's a channel named Inside NX Post Configurator, and inside of the Inside Post Configurator channel, you have currently two playlists. The one is the webinar sessions with all the sessions we did in the past, and additionally also the Post Configurator general training videos. So yeah, just for your information, so you can get into this channel, take a look on the videos and relook the videos if you like. And for future, it's also planned that we have a third playlist here that is then named NX Post Configurator Tech Tips. Those are more or less than 3 4 minutes videos with some techniques, really techniques for Post Configurator to develop the post processor. Okay, just want to mention it. So feel free to join this channel. I would be happy. Okay, then today more a topic, automation post processing or automation in general with Post Configurator. Just in a short introduction, I'm pretty sure not everybody is dealing with the NX Open API. So let me say some words about it, what it is. So NX Open API, it's an interface in NX, in general in NX, where you can automate processes. So you can write your own extensions with C Sharp, C++, Python, and so on. And the most of the functionality in NX, in general in NX, can be automated by those journals or directly the API. You can easily create projects. You just can using it's like what we named journal. I will show in a second or in a minute. And also you can use, for example, Visual Studio for more complex projects. Visual Studio. You can also use the free edition. It's what is the name? I forget what the name. So it's but it's for free. Everybody can use it also for commercial things. So what is the advantage when I talk about automation at the end in this context of post-processing, for example? So you can take a lot of benefit, for example, for time savings. Means you can create post-processors based on your own configuration script files automatically without clicking in the UI and so on. That I will show in a minute. And also, it's for example possible to add additional functionality behind it, for example, like auto-generated documentation of a post-processor. So, I mean, today it's a case, people develop a post-processor and then they write documentation by hand. Or most of them, not all. So, why not automate those processes? That also means you have to, or you need a standard coding at the end in your TCL that you can extract this information and automatically create those documents and so on. On the second side, quality, for sure. All the time you want to be sure that your post processor is still working for new features for in NX versions. And maybe you also want to test your post processor under certain conditions, like okay, what is the behavior if I use for example Synumeric CK800, what is the behavior if I use the transrot options in Post Configurator? And additionally on that is I think an we have all of us to deal with is this continuous release of NX. At the end, we have now more shortened cycles for new versions, and that means it's really more important to have those automated testing implementation to test the things automatically, the basic things. Not, I mean, you not can test everything automated for sure, but basic things you can directly use scripts, can test it, can run it, and compare it. So, and that means at the end you can really that's okay, concentrate. Okay, you can concentrate really on the testing of the new features and not on all older things. And also if a customer want to move up to in this continuous release to a newer version, you have to ensure all the things are working. And so this is a possibility how to do it. So let me show it on a simple sample at the end and how it works. So let me go to NX here. Okay. So in general, let me open the standard SIM5 part here. So the first basic thing how to get information, or how to, I mean, you don't have to read a lot of documentation how to get the information, what you have to code at the end. The first important thing is in the menu preferences, user interface. You have under tools, journal, you have the language, how, what I will do in a second, how it's recorded. So that means if you prefer C sharp, use C sharp. If you prefer Visual Basic, use Visual Basic, Python, Java, C++. This is dependent on maybe also on your experience. So I normally use C sharp. That is the first setting you have to do, and the second setting you have to do under menus, journal, and then we can say, okay, I want to record a journal. That means every interaction I will do in NX now will be recorded in a file. So, okay, let's name it Journal 2. And when you now take a look in the UI, you see all these green small points here. That means this functionality is recorded. There are also sometimes functionality which is very old, which is introduced in one of the first versions, or more or less in previous versions. Older versions, which is not supported by the NX Open API, but maybe by what we named user functions. Nevertheless, you see the most of the things can be recorded. So, and this is, for example, one of the things we want to achieve also with Post Configurator, that you have more connection to the system and that you can do those things. So this is not possible with at the end external tools really. So at the end, let us do one test here. I want to create a post processor, create a new post processor, and let me use this as a name here, pretest, and save it here. I want to create a directory. I want to have the Cinemaric out of the box layer and the simple machine level. And click OK. And additionally on that, let's keep it simple for today. Let me change the access leader, for example. So Y1, Z1. And additionally on that, to just see it, plain output. We say okay, TCPM output is supported. Let's just say off. So now we save the modifications and click OK. Now when I stop the recording and let me go to the hard disk to show what is recorded here. That is for the second one in a second. Journals. So at the end, this is what we named journal. It's really basic functionality, and all the actions I did are now recorded here. That means, okay, I create a new post configurator object, then I give it a post processor name, I give it an output directory, which layer are used. I say okay, create the post processor here, and at the end all those things between those are the undo marks. Normally you can remove them if it's not needed, and at the end it create here the post processor. And after that, I set, for example, properties. So this is also recorded. That means if I change something in the UI, it's recorded and I can now use this information. At the end, this shows the property definition of the post processor, in this case, MomSys Leader, and set it to X1. And at the end, I save it, and that's it. So what I now can do, two things I can do. So first, let me go back to my hard disk here and say, okay, I will delete this created post configurator here. So out of the box, what you can do with NX, so far you have the journal license, if I remember correctly. You can now say, okay, tools journal play and this is journal number two and just one. So that means all the steps are now automated. It creates a post processor. For sure, the UI is not open. But now the post processor exists again here. It's new created, 9 o'clock, 9 o'clock, was a second before. And when I open this one, it directly have those predefined settings like, okay, TCP admin output is off. And my real machine kinematics are X1, Y1, Z1. So this is just as a short sample that the complete UI of Post Configurator is NX Open supported. That means you can do everything also with additional automation processes. And I mean, this is a very simple one. Just record the journal and reuse it, or you can also edit this one in the editor here in NX. So means you can say edit, but for sure you don't have functionality like auto completion and so on. So you have to really to be sure what you do. The second way, this is a more efficient way from my perspective, is to have it in a Visual Studio project. So as I mentioned, this Visual Studio basic version is free. Everybody can download, everybody can use it. And at the end, there are. Let me show it here. I just want to show a small thing here for auto documentation today. So first, there's a wizard. So that means you can automatically create a standard entry point at the end. What we it's from the wizard created with program. Then you have the constructor, and inside of this constructor, at this point you call your application code. Then, in this case, what I prepared here is for today. It's auto documentation. That means the post processor I created. I want to create an auto documentation of settings, of the overview, of the post processor itself, and so on. For sure, this is an additional extension you have to write. Just to explain short what happens here. First, there's this is really a big advantage. You can reuse a lot of open source things. And for example, this PDF Sharp, it's an open source library which helps you to create PDF documents. So, and in this case, what we do, okay, we create a new documentation with this post processor file. In this case, or for today, it's hard coded here, so you can also do it with a open file dialog, whatever. And at the end, it create now a PDF page here. And in a second, you will see here. This is, for example, information from the journal file. That means I set here get here the current machine mode. Means I open a post configurator builder object, get the property value of this conf SPF machine, what you get out of a post configurator UI or when you journal it, and then just gets the information and puts this on this document. So this can be, you can extend it in every constellation you want. So for example, you can also pass the TCL file then if you have a coding standard, gets this information out and put like a post processor documentation inside of it. So how does it works? As I mentioned, I hard coded this one, so that is why I use the name pretest for the post processor. In this case, when I now run this application, it will go to this folder pretest TCL. This is this one. Will open the post configurator in the background in NX. Will get all the information and will create a PDF document in this folder for documentation. So let's have a try. Maybe also let me move the machine here, that we see it in a second, a little bit different. In general, when you have an extension in like a Visual Studio, you just do a build solution. And in NX, you can call it two possibilities, a control U, then it will open execute user function. and you just point to the build DLL. So let me click OK. So, and maybe not sure from the frame rate, maybe you see the machine tool also, this image was oriented in a true shading view automatically. And it's done. And now in this folder, in this pretest folder, I have a document here named documentation PDF. And when I open this one, then it's at the end it's based on a PDF template with what we internally use here and on the Siemens side. It contains the post-processor name, it contains the controller, it contains the image which was oriented automatically, that it's maybe it's we can do some improvements here of the view. But at the end now we have this general information. What is it? It's a mill, it's 5-axis dual table, it's the numeric 840D. What is the unit? It's a part. Part means metric and inch. TCPM output supported, for example, is none. And additionally on that, this is also something we have to work a little bit on the formatting. But for example, also the linear axes are now X1, Y1, Z1. And for example, this is a good documentation you just can give to the customer or from partner side if they are interested in a post processor. And there are no limits to extend those functionalities. For example, also to include TCL documentation, as I mentioned. So let me show one thing again. We delete this. This here. Go back to NX and let me say, okay, I changed something now on the post processor. Now it's TCPM, it's on. And this is transport, and it's now a mill turn, and it's a 3-axis mill turn. And save this modification. So, and instead of writing this document by hand, just let me execute again and done. So that means this change, I changed my post processor and the documentation is created in 2 seconds. And it's now directly updated. So now it's mill, I mean, doesn't matter that this is not a mill turn, but it's now mill turn, 3-axis mill turn. TCPM is supported, plane output is supported. My axis leader again is X, Y, Z. So this is really how you really can do effective documentation if you like. Yeah, think that's it. And I mean, really, also for the post processor itself. You can, we have projects here, for example, you can connect it with the SQL database. Means you store the part file there, run the post process automatically, and compare the output, for example, what is stored in the database from this current post process one. And this is can be really powerful for sure. You need some programming skills in additional languages like C Sharp, Python, or Visual Basic, C++. But a lot of the things you directly get from these journals here. That means if you want to know which functionality is behind, just record the journal and reuse this information in your code. Okay, any questions to that? Remarks? This sounds like a no. So then, because the last 2 times I think I extend the meeting, then I would say for today, it's all. Or in general, do you have any other topics you want to discuss before I close this meeting? Any other questions, remarks, remarks to Florian's cool presentation of Posthub?
Thomas, one question.
Yes.
Is it possible to modify this template as per our requirement?
Yes. At the end, what you do is very easy.
Like if you want to add some additional information regarding the homing positions or something like that, is it possible to modify?
Yes, you can do that.
Okay.
At the end, so what? Let me short, very in short explain. What you do here, it's at the end, this is like a template PDF, okay? So,
okay.
And this template, you can create it with Word, whatever. Have a style, it's have empty fields, it's have predefined information I want to print into this document, right? So all the
yeah.
right side is empty. And the only thing you have to do then in the coding itself, like in this auto documentation here, at the end, for example, you get the property here, and then you have to draw the string of this property at the correct place. This is it's more, yeah, it's work to do, you have to do. And at the end, you can then say, okay, where is the location of it, and you have to align it a little bit. So, but
okay.
In general, you can extend it with multiple things. Also, for example, existing UDEs, right? So what are the existing UDEs of this post processor? Just pass the files and outputs all the UDEs with additional informations and so on. In this case, it's just a two-pager, just as a sample, what I want to show. So you can also extend it with multiple pages. So at the end, this is just saying here, okay, we create two pages, and those two pages contains then all the things.
Okay, Thomas, it's great and it's helpful. Thank
yeah,
you.
But it's work. So I mean, so you first, you know, in general, all the time you have to invest first some work, and then you can get a great benefit out of it. And like this documentation things, I think, especially in the post-processor world, documentation things sometimes are very good, sometimes are very bad. So and to find a standard, also for post-hub at the end, we plan those kind of documents in a more extended way, that you have directly more information of the kit itself, what it is, what can it, what is, yeah, that's the idea behind it.
Thanks, Thomas.
You're welcome. Okay, so then it seems there are no more questions or remarks. Then, yeah, let's keep it short today. I wish you all have a nice weekend, and thanks for joining this meeting. And again, thanks to Florian for his presentation. So, talk to you in 6 weeks again. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Thanks,
Bye.
Thomas.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.
Thanks, Thomas.